guys, today I'm going to present you the geometric dispersion effects for Adobe Photoshop. It's a new action script that creates this really cool effect for your photo, for your image. And it's really fun to play with. Let me show you some of the previews. This is a starting photo. It is the effect. It creates these really nice polygons and shapes, lines all around your subject. You can modify everything in the layers panel. Later I will show you. And it creates all this explosion of shapes and stuff. It's really, really cool. So let's see how to install it and use it. First of all, we go to the download folder where we download the geometric dispersion effects and we extract the file. Inside you will find the patterns, the guide, the geometric dispersion effects, some variation of the effects, which is basically the same but with a bit of variation, and the effects tool. I made another tutorial where I show you how to use the effects tool, which is an extension for Adobe Photoshop. First of all, we have to close Photoshop. Then we go to the geometric dispersion effects. We click it and we copy it. Then we navigate to the script folder into Photoshop, which is located into your local disk, program files, Adobe, Adobe Photoshop and the version that you're using, presets, scripts. Once you're here, just paste and then you click continue. And this way you have the geometric dispersion effects installed. We go to the pattern and we double click. This way we will also install the patterns and open Photoshop at the same time. Now that we have opened Photoshop, we choose the image that we want to work with. And we also check if the patterns are installed. We go to the paint bucket tool. We switch to pattern and we see that they are in our library. Also, we can check if the script is installed, which is right here, under scripts, geometric dispersion effects. So to make this effect, we need to create a new layer and paint the area where we want effect. To do that, we can use any tool we want, the pen tool, the lasso tool. In this case, I'm just going to use quickly the brush tool to show you what type of the effect we get just using this brush. So once we made our selection, it's on a new layer, it's visible, and also the background is visible. The name of this layer doesn't matter, and also the image size will influence the final result. In this case, the image is pretty small, so it will be enlarged to work correctly. Then you can export it again to the original size. But if you are working with a bigger image, with an image for example of 5000 pixels, it will not be resized. So you will always have a perfect result, no matter what the resolution of your image is. So once you have these conditions, your mask done and your background visible, you go to File, Scripts, and Geometric Dispersion Effects. These effects work with any Photoshop version and in any language. Let's see what it does. Okay, that is a pretty good result. Let's watch it on another one. This time we're going to apply the effect on this motorbike, and it's really a nice effect if you want to give movement to the photo, like in this case. And we are going to use the FxBox, which is a free extension. It's the same that go into File, Scripts, Geometric Dispersion Effects. But this way you have the panel, it's way more useful, you can add more effects. I suggest you to get it because it's a free extension and you can add more effects. You go here and we click apply this effect. So this is the final result, guys. As you can see, it's pretty cool. There are all these shapes and polygons all around your subject, creating this sense of movement. Now in the next example, we are going to use another type of selection, and I'm also going to show you how to modify some of the layers and how the document is structured. But as you can see, it's all layered, and you can modify everything and make it your own artwork. So that was the result that you get with a brush tool, for example. Let's try this time to use a polygonal lasso tool for a more undefined selection. Everything that you do at this stage will influence the final artwork. So if you do a more defined selection, it will be a lot more polygonal, and if you use, for example, the pen tool, the effect will be more defined. And the action script revolves around what you do at this stage. So when you experiment, you will find out that there are many variations of the effect on the same photo that you can get. So it's really fun to play with, and let's try it on this photo. Create a new layer, fill it with any color, and then go to File, Scripts, and choose Geometric Dispersion Effects. Alright, very nice result already. As you can see, there are all these shapes and polygons, lines and patterns creating from the selection and the subject. So let's see what we can do and customize. First of all, we have the original photo intact in the background and the starting selection. Then we have the background texture, which is basically the base texture and some lines that sometimes are not very visible. It depends. Then we have the colored shapes, which is red shapes, and you can of course modify and change the color and the aspect of it. First of all, sometimes it's even better to just remove it, and the image will work very well. Let's try to set up another color. Try to use, for example, a very bright purple. And let's try to change blending mode. At this stage, you can do whatever you want. It's your work now, and you can do whatever you think looks good. So let's try, for example, this one, soft light. Then in the middle shapes, you find all these deconstructed polygons around the selection. Let's see what's inside. The outside shapes, pencil pattern, which is a very subtle pattern that you can see with the silhouette of the figure, the extra shapes, and the lines. This one. Sometimes the lines are very visible, sometimes they're not. It depends on your selection again. As you saw before, we got a totally different effect. And the extra shapes, for example, we can add some color to that as well. Let's add a similar color. A slightly different one. Then we have a layer in blue, invisible, called the reveal back. If we select the layer mask, we go with the brush tool, but with a white one, select a normal brush. We can paint back parts of the original photo. I had this selected, which is a splatter brush. These are free assets that you can find online. If you search on Google for free splatter brushes, you'll find many. And you can, for example, reveal back the background image using a different effect. This is just an example. You can do whatever you want. In the front shapes, you have the main figure and the main shape. And what you can do in this part is modify its blending options, because its layer style, sorry, because they have applied some effect to give some depth to the composition. Then we have the adjustments. In the adjustments, I made some pre-made adjustment layers. In this case, I would modify the background, for example, because the starting image is very dark, so I think a dark background works. And also, there is a layer called outside shapes that we can rotate, linking the layer mask. If we do that, we can select the layer mask, hit Ctrl T or Command T, and rotate. So we can find other shapes and other patterns. In the front shapes, there is a layer called back shapes. This layer has an effect with a white inner shadow. By default, the background is white, so this layer will create some sort of transparency. So if we change this color, for example, to a very dark one, we will create this transparency effect, where we it's like translucent, because you can barely see what's behind. This layer, you can, for example, try different blending options. Will probably come out with something interesting. Another thing that I suggest you to do is to create a new curve adjustment layer. Then you click on the warning icon. Then you go here and you select auto options. Then you go to find dark and light colors. This is the best algorithm usually. Then you click OK. At this point we can do something like the background image is black, full black. We can maybe move the black point a bit and increase the contrast. So as you can see, in a few minutes you can make a really nice artwork. Thanks guys for watching, and please follow me on Instagram and Dribbble and Twitter, and show me what you create with these tools, and if you get them, they're really cheap and it's worth it. I hope you will have fun, and see ya in the next one.